The reactivity of boron contrasts with that found for the heavier elements in the group, which is attributed for its metalloid character. For instance, all elements except boron exhibit a well-defined aqueous chemistry, forming highly hydrated species such as the hexaquo cations in acid media or tetrahydroxide metallates for a basic pH. Boron does not react with water and is resistant to non-oxidizing acids such as hydrogen chloride, although it reacts with oxidizing acids forming boric acid. It reacts with air only when heated to form diboron trioxide. This species is an acidic oxide which reacts with water to form boric acid. This type of reaction, which is more typical for a non-metal element, shows the different behavior of boron with respect to the rest of the elements of the group. A reaction that becomes even more apparent is the reaction of boron with metals to form borides, such as. This reaction is not reproducible for aluminum, gallium, and indium, and their oxides behave in a very different way. The thin metals form the respective trioxide compounds when heated with the metal with oxygen in the case of aluminum and gallium, or the nitrite or sulfide salt for indium. However, the trioxide show a markedly difference concerning their acid-base behavior with respect to what has been described for boron. In this sense, while aluminum and gallium oxide are amphoteric and react with both acids and base, indium oxide is base in aqueous solution. Thallium, on the other hand, is able to form two types of oxides, dithallium oxide and dithallium trioxide, being the former the most stable. Oxide of thallium 1 is clearly basic and reacts with water to form thallium hydroxide, which is a very soluble and strong base. Obviously, we should be careful comparing the basicity of dithallium oxide with the oxide of the rest of the elements in oxidation state 3+. Clearly, those combinations in their lower oxidation state are more basic than in their higher oxidation state. In addition, this increase of the basic features as we move down in the group is also manifested when we examine the elements themselves. In that sense, while boron dissolves readily in fused alkalis, indium and thallium are not attacked by alkalis at all. All the elements react with halogens to form the corresponding three halides, although thallium also forms thallium 1 halides. Even though they don't combine directly with hydrogen, a huge number of hydrides of these elements have been obtained by indirect methods. Interestingly, boron trihalides are found as monomers, while these species are dimers for aluminum, gallium, and indium due to their high size, which allows to coordinate a 4-halogen atom. The monomeric boron trihalides possess trigonal planar structure where the boron adopts an sp2 hybridization and a vacant p orbital perpendicular to the plane. This empty orbital is the reason why they behave as Lewis acids accepting pair of electron for Lewis bases. The power to accept the lone pair is contrary to that expected on the basis of the electronegatives of the halogens. This anomalous behavior is explained based on the relative tendency of the halogens atom to donate back its electron through a pp-pp interaction. As a result of this back donation of electron from the halogens to boron, the electron deficiency is reduced and its Lewis acid character is decreased. The tendency to form this type of bonding is maximum for boron trifluoride and diminishes as we move to boron trichloride, boron tribromide, and boron triiodide. Probably due to that difference in energy between the 2p orbital of the boron and the 3p, 4p, and 5p orbital of chlorine, bromine, and iodine, respectively. Therefore, the stronger Lewis acid is exhibited by boron tribromide, followed by boron trichloride, and finally boron tribromide. For ligands containing mild acid protons such as water, alcohols, or even amines, chlorides, bromides, and iodides are susceptible to protolysis, being even explosives for boron tribromide and boron triiodide.